In season one, Joe explains the basics of recording palettes, but now we're going to go into a little bit more detail. You should load the show for video 2.4 if you're following along. Let's start with looking at some different recording options for palettes. These are global, per type, and per fixture. A global palette is one that contains values that can be applied to any fixture, so long as they have the parameters. These fixtures can be added to your show at any time and still use existing global palettes. By default, where there's just a single fixture, or all the fixture's values in the programmer are the same, then color, beam, and effect palettes are stored as global palettes. For example, if I go ahead and release my playback state on stage with pig release, and then select my table color source pars and turn them on, if I mix a color, even though I have several fixtures in the programmer, they're all set to the same color. And so if I store this as a color palette with record followed by a destination in the color directory, then if I clear my programmer and open up this color, we can see that it is a global palette. I can now apply this palette to any type of fixture, such as the table pars and also the floor buttons. A per-fixture palette contains values for specific fixtures only. By default, intensity and position palettes are stored as per-fixture. For example, if I open my stage right lectern position palette, you can see that it only contains values for two fixtures, 201 and 202. When I select either of those fixtures, I can use the palette. But if I select other fixtures, then it grays out, indicating that it cannot be used with my current fixture selection. The third type of palette is per type. This means all fixtures of that type will be able to use the palette, but no others. However, it may be the case that you have a global palette with a per type value merged into it. This would mean most fixtures would use the global value, whilst fixtures of a certain type only would use the per type value. There isn't a default for initially creating a per-type palette like there is for global and per-fixture, but I'll cover this in more detail in the next video. Although there is the default behavior when recording palettes, which depends on the destination directory, at any point I could store a color palette as per-type or per-fixture, for example, rather than global, by choosing one of those two options after pressing record. Similarly, if I take a single fixture on my back truss, move it and then record, choose the option of global, then all of my fixtures will be able to use that global value. It may well be that you always want to allow additional kinds into a directory. For example, it can be useful to have position and beam in the same palette. Up to now, I've shown you how to mask in kinds by pressing on the mask menu on the screen or by using the syntax of mask followed by command. For example, position, beam, record. We can actually change the default recording mask of a directory by pressing on this legend, adding in beam, followed by apply, and you can see in the legend now that position and beam are both highlighted blue. This will now allow position and beam information to be recorded by default. For example, I'm now going to create my stage left lectern palette. I'll select those fixtures, move them into position, and then adjust the zoom size. Now I don't want to risk any other parameters such as gobo from changing how the lectern is lit. This is a good example of how touch can be used. If I now press touch, I have basically taken a snapshot of these fixtures parameters as I see them right now and brought those values into the programmer. Since all the values are now record eligible, I know that whenever I apply this palette, the position and beam parameters will look exactly as they do now. So to record this, I can simply press record followed by a destination in the position directory. Even though I haven't changed the mask, either via the command line or in the mask menu, position and beam will be recorded as the new default because of the change I made to the default mask in the directory itself. Now that I've stored the palette, you can see that it contained position and beam information, just like the stage right lectern palette I'd previously stored. Moving back to the options toolbar, another option that can be chosen when recording palettes is allow refs. This allows one palette to reference a series of other palettes, making it quick to apply multiple palettes to fixtures all at once. For example, I have some beam palettes of gobos here, and a few palettes for different beam focuses. To create a generic look palette for these solar frame 1500s, I can either apply the position, the color, and the various beam palettes each time, or I could record one generic palette that references all the others. We can make use of the syntax now from the previous video and type our masks. So, beam, color, position, record. And note how position, color, and beam are now masked in on the mask menu, followed by the allow refs option. And then press our destination. An R symbol appears in the corner, letting us know that this palette is referencing others. If I clear the programmer, now whenever I want these fixtures to go straight to that generic look, I can just select the fixtures, turn them on, and put them in my generic palette. If at any point I need to adjust the focus, for example, I can simply edit that one beam palette, and everywhere I've programmed with the generic look palette will also be changed. In the next video, we'll take a detailed look at how to edit palettes.